class. This is your professor, Jim Smart, for your web-based intro stats class, STA 2023. And this is the first in a series of videos to show you how to do some things in the class, most particularly how to use your calculator. And in this first video, we're going to look at the most basic part of using the calculator, which is how to enter data onto the calculator using lists. Lists are the most important function that you need to learn. And without using lists, you will have difficulty doing just about anything else in our stats class. So let's take a look at an example from the notes. Go over to resources on your Blackboard page. Click on that. And then in class notes, these are from my on-site classes at TCC. Test 1 notes. And then we'll go down to the Module 2 notes, the annotated topic 2.1 and 2.2 notes. And that will open in a new window. And I'm going to scroll down here to the second page and look at these heart rates that were from some students in a previous class. Okay, I'll pull up my calculator, and hopefully you've got yours handy. I have the computer-based one, but it's nice for letting you see what I'm doing. All right, so I'm on the home screen. I've got my little cursor blinking here. And what I do is I press the stat key to the lower left of the arrows. And then I'm going to go over, I'm going to do choice one edit. And anytime you're working with a menu like this, you can either press enter or you can press the number of the selection. So I usually go with the number, so there's no one. Oh, so these are the lists, L1, L2, L3, and they go on out to L6. You can even create your own lists. I won't show you how to do that. It's not very difficult, but you probably won't need to do it for our class, so I'll leave that out for the moment. But notice there's already some numbers here in our lists. I don't really need these numbers, so I need to clear them out. In order to clear them out, you need to go up and highlight the name of the list. Right now I'm on the first entry of the list, so I'll press the up arrow, and now I've highlighted list 1. You see down here it actually gives you all the numbers in the list. And one common mistake that sometimes students do is they'll press the delete key. And notice I didn't clear the list. The list is just gone. If I press delete again, now I don't have list 1 or list 2. You might think, well, what if I just press the left arrow? Well, it just goes out back to list 6. When I get to list 3 again, press the left arrow, list 6. This is a common thing, so I wanted to show you how you fix this if you do it to your own calculator. You press the stat key again, but this time you go to choice 5, setup editor, click it. Click number 5 on your calculator and hit enter. It'll say done. And now if you go to stat and edit again, the lists are back and the numbers are still there. So not only did you cause yourself a bit of a headache, but you didn't even succeed in doing what you wanted to do in the first place. The real way to get rid of the numbers in the list is to go back up, highlight the name of the list, and press clear rather than delete. And then either enter or the down arrow, and the numbers are gone. And I'll do that also for list 2. Press the up arrow so that I'm highlighted on the list. Press clear. And this time I'll press the down arrow to show you it does exactly the same thing. Now I'm going to go back to list 1. And you'll hear some clicking because I'm not going to actually use the arrow key to type in the numbers. I'm going to use the number pad on my computer. But of course you would type the number like 63 for the first heart rate and press enter. And then 70, enter. And then 52, enter, and so on. Now I'm going to pause the video here and keep typing in the numbers so you don't have to sit there at your computer and wait for me to do it. So I'll pause for one moment and I will be back and the numbers will all be filled in on my calculator. Okay, now I've resumed the video. Ooh. I've lost my calculator. Here's my calculator. And you see here, my last number is 90. Corresponds with the 90 here. And you'll see it says L1 parentheses 46. That means the blank where I am here is the 46th entry of my list. And number 90 is actually the 90th, is actually the 45th entry. If I press the up arrow, you'll see that it says L1 parentheses 45 equals 90. And that means 90 is the 45th entry in the list. So that concludes the entering data into the calculator. I want to keep these videos short, sweet, and to the point. and so that you'll be easily able to find the video that you need. So stay tuned for the next video for learning on how to do a histogram using these data.